December 5 and 20, boom, boom, boom. On December 5 and 20, boom, boom, boom. For the love of all the world is born a child, is born a child. In a manger golden, though we hear the newborn infant holy, boom, boom, boom.
Keyboard's not working, so we're not going to do that one. You'll hear Angels We Have Heard in High instead.
Angels We Have Heard on High, sweetly singing o'er the plains and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains. Gloria in excelsis.
morning, and congratulations to all the nominees for Student of the Month. Once again, we are sophomore Madison Singers. Thank you very much.
Good morning and welcome to the Student of the Month breakfast. My name is Brian Radovich. I'm the assistant principal for the freshman class here of 2022. It's my pleasure to be hosting this event, and it's indeed an honor for those students to be recognized considering the large population here at LT. The students being honored today will be presented by their nominating teachers, and the teachers will share why their students have been nominated. However, because of their teaching schedules, some teachers will need to go out to prepare to teach, so please forgive any comings and goings that occurred during the presentations. And without further ado, we are going to start. The first to present is Ms. Soxtelis from the Family and Consumer Sciences Department, and she is presenting two students, Audrey and Olivia. You guys can come on up.
Thank you. Okay, first I'd like to give you a little explanation of the class I teach. Both of these ladies are in my Child Development 2 class. And in that class, they are required to plan lessons and teach them to a group of sometimes rowdy preschoolers. And these two have continually gone above and beyond. They've had some obstacles that were nothing that they could have controlled and handled it with poise and grace and didn't skip a beat in making sure that our littlest lions, our 3 to 5 year old preschoolers had the best experience possible. How great these girls are. Already they have a lesson coming up on Monday and Tuesday and have told me how excited they are for what they're going to teach, and they won't tell me what it is. So I'm on pins and needles waiting to see what's going to happen on Monday and Tuesday with our preschoolers, but I'm also very confident it's going to be pretty great. So these two make me smile every day. They are always happy. They're always smiling, just like they are now. And they make sure that the preschooler's experience is exactly what we would want it to be. So I thank them for being in my class, and I hope to see them in future classes as well. So thank you, ladies.
Thank you.
Great job, Audrey and Olivia. Next, we have Ms. Wilcox from Business Education, and she's going to be presenting Henry.
Good morning. I first met Henry this summer during summer school. He took keyboarding with me. I would say most days he was pretty quiet, a little sleepy, so I didn't get to know him very well, plus it was only 6 weeks. But come to find out, he was doing swim often in the morning, so he was getting up at 5 a.m., so I can understand why he was pretty tired. Now I have Henry in my introduction to business class. I've gotten to know Henry, and he is definitely the student that you want in your classroom. He's always upbeat, he participates, he helps the students around him, and he has an overall great attitude. We do a Shark Tank project in Intro to Business, and so we recently finished it, and the students create a product or service, make a prototype, write a business plan, and then present that plan to a panel of business professionals. When we picked partners at the beginning of the semester, I don't think Henry knew too many people in the class at that time, so he ended up with someone he didn't know very well. From the beginning, Henry took the lead on this project. And as we all know, working with people is not always easy, especially when the members of the group don't share the same passion and motivation. So Henry did struggle a bit with his partner. He communicated the problems he was having with me right away, which is not always easy to do. He also continued to communicate and did his best to work with his partner, letting him know what he needed to do for the project. So he was really taking the lead the entire time. As Henry was working on the project, I could see that he wasn't just doing it to get the grade, which happens a lot, or just to get the job done. He was taking ownership of his business plan and loved his ideas. His idea was to make and sell mini pies, so kind of like how we always buy cupcakes, right? So he decided to do mini pies. Henry worked on his project in class diligently and even spent a considerable amount of time working on it outside of class. When he presented, he showed his enthusiasm, he was confident, and had great energy. I was very proud of Henry for all of his hard work and persistence. It was wonderful to watch Henry work and see his eyes light up when he came up with unique and creative ideas. I don't think Henry was very interested in business when he signed up for this class. Maybe he's changed his mind, I'm not sure. I also asked Henry to come to Future Freshman Night to talk to eighth graders about intro to business, and you know, without even a second thinking about it, he said yes, so I can always rely on Henry. He's a pleasure to have in class, and I'm very happy to nominate him for Student of the Month. Thank you.
Great job, Henry. Sounds like we may see you on the real Shark Tank soon. Next, we have Mr. Meist from Music, and he's going to present Isabel.
Hello. Sorry, I'm kind of tall. I'm Mr. Meisty, and this is Isabel Gonzalez, and I wanted to recognize her today for her outstanding job in concert band. To tell you a little bit about concert band, or at least concert band as a freshman, at the end of your eighth grade year, you sort of find out you're doing this crazy thing called marching band next year, and you have a meeting about it in June, and then 2 weeks before school starts, you meet with the upperclassmen out on Bennett Field over here. You do 2 weeks of about 3 hour marching rehearsals for about eight rehearsals. You learn two-thirds of the show, and then by the first week of school, you're pretty much ready for a performance. You come in as a eighth grader thinking you finally got it figured out because you sort of know how to play your instrument at this point, but then we're like, no, you have to learn how to move and play at this point. Well, Isabel did none of that. She came in completely fresh. Isabel is not only new as a freshman, but you are transferring in, which means we didn't really know you existed before school started. And then also, she's completely brand new to the hardest instrument in the band, French horn. So Isabel shows up for the first day of school, and she not only did not know how to really play the French horn, you had a little bit of training on it, but she realized that she missed the marching band component where you learn how to move and do all the show stuff. And most people would have said, well, I'm gonna go talk to the counselor, I'm gonna drop out, because clearly this is too much makeup work to have to do. And that wasn't what Isabel said. She came to the rehearsals, she started working with our other horn players, other upperclassmen, she learned the marching maneuvers. Even something that sounds as simple as like learning the French horn, she didn't even just get to do that, because with the marching band, we don't march actual French horns because they point backwards. I don't know if you've seen it. They're the curlicue ones that shoot backwards. So she had to learn the special mellophone, which has a completely different set of fingerings as well, and uses a different mouthpiece. So it was really the trying to build the airplane as it's taking off situation that she was doing. And she did a great job with it. She knew what she had to do. She started taking private lessons. She started practicing. We tried to get her as much help as she can, but ultimately, you know, the beginning of the school year is a very challenging time. So much of her success just came from her own personal motivation to try, to practice, to stick with it. And you know, marching season's only a small part of our program. We got to the first concert at the end of October, and for her being completely new to French horn, there was just all these moments, like there's this horn solo. It's only a single note, but it's a super important note at the end of American River Songs. And like, I get off the podium and I'm talking to Mr. Dahl and I'm like, did you hear that? Did you hear that F? It was really good. Her I don't know the name of the teacher who put you on French horn, but he did a great job of choosing that instrument for you. Her most recent accomplishments, in band, we test in front of her peers. So not only is she on a completely new instrument, but she's testing in front of all of her friends and being able to list off the notes of scales, being able to play them confidently. This new piece we have, Foundry, has more exposed high range notes that most first year performers can't play. So I think she's just done an incredible job. We couldn't be more proud of the work she's done. So help me recognize Isabel Gonzalez.
Great job, Isabel. Sounds like a lot of perseverance there. Next, we have Mr. White, who's going to present Andrew from Algebra 2.
First, I'd like to thank everybody who put this together, from the breakfast to the nice tables. And so thank you for that, and thank all the parents who came in maybe extra early or maybe going to work late. Thank you for taking the time. I know I always appreciate it when my parents took the time to come to whatever I was involved in. And so thank you. And thank you to Andrew's mother for coming this morning. And I got to meet her a few times. So you've done a good job with him, and I'm sure you'll continue. A little bit about my class. I teach math. It's everybody's favorite subject growing up. It's the one everybody goes rah-rah as they enter class. I'm super excited to be in math today. Right, Andrew?
Yep.
Yeah, there it is. The excitement. It's everybody's easiest subject, too. Don't have to put much work in, correct? You don't work for my class?
No.
It's easy. Interesting. We got a test today. I think I might have to make it a little harder. I got a few hours before you take it. But anyways, I'll stick to my notes. So Andrew's been a tremendous example to his classmates and to myself this school year. He's a hard worker who is willing to participate and help others. Andrew definitely brightens the room whenever he enters, as he comes to class each day with a big smile on his face. I think he's nervous right now, but normally there's a smile on. There it is. Now let's rewind about 7 months. Just for a second, but in May 2018, Andrew was diagnosed with a rare liver disease that has no treatment or cure, and it's progressive. Many people face difficult circumstances, but few handle these circumstances with the maturity that Andrew has shown. Andrew recently shared his story at Young Life Banquet to a room full of kids and adults. I got to watch that video. His mother shared that with me. Andrew's a constant reminder to me that no matter what difficult circumstances come my way, I can keep my chin up and focus on the positives. Thank you, Andrew, for the positive example that you display each and every day to me and to others. Many people don't know, but for me and others who do know, it's incredibly encouraging. Thank you for the positive influence you've had on my life and the lives you've come into contact with on a daily basis. I pray for a cure and for many more years of being able to be blessed by your life. So thank you, Andrew, and keep up the good work, and look forward to many more years of you being a good example to me and many others. So thank you, Andrew.
Awesome job, Andrew. Next, we have Mr. Gamboa, who is going to present Catherine.
Good morning. Unfortunately, she wasn't able to be here today. And that's one of the challenges, one of the many challenges our students face sometimes. It could be transportation, but I know she's here in spirit. But I'd love to share, regardless, some of the attributes of why I awarded Catherine the Student of the Month Award. Catherine is a student who stands out for many reasons, but the main reason I have chosen her for this award is her appreciation and motivation for learning. Every day, Catherine respectfully enters our classroom, and every day she brings such positive energy and a desire to advance in her academic work. She does this while being kind and helpful through her willingness to work with others, assist her classmates in any of the challenges they may face. This is a key attribute in any language classroom, but even more so in a beginning language learning classroom, where students are striving to improve every language domain in order to become proficient and succeed in all the different academic challenges that LT offers. Catherine's ability to always be responsible, hardworking, positive, has made her a great asset to our classroom as well as our LT community. We thank Catherine for everything that she does in our classroom and for everything she does for the LT community. And I'll be sure to share all this with her as well as the award. And thank you, Catherine.
Next, we have Ms. Gibbons from World Languages, who is going to present another Catherine.
Good morning. I'm so honored to get to stand in front of you and introduce Katie to you. I'll go with a different name. Katie has been with me for 2 years in class now in the brand new American Sign Language program, and I'm so glad she took that gamble and signed up for a brand new program last year. I didn't get to know Katie right away. She is one of those students who is always working and always thinking, but very quietly. She's very shy, and I constantly find myself thinking, I hope all of her teachers get to know Katie the way that I've been fortunate enough to get to know Katie. She has such a wonderful personality when she, you know, feels comfortable in an environment, and she is a critical thinker. She is always asking questions, and now that I've really gotten to know her, she is an amazing participant in class. In addition, she is a large participant in the American Sign Language Club. And when this opportunity came to nominate a student, it was very clear that Katie was the right choice. Her positive attitude, her positive energy, her willingness to help her peers, and to expand the knowledge of our class by asking those thinker questions that, you know, maybe require a little bit more attention to the subject at hand, are always something that Katie is willing to do. Katie has been an amazing student. You know, the grades have never been a concern because she works so hard, but she's an amazing person as well, and I just enjoy seeing Katie every day in class. So thank you, Katie.
Great job, Katie. Next we have Ms. Bronuskas, hopefully I'm pronouncing that correctly, from the Science Department, and she's going to present Olivia.
All right, good morning. Mr. White, I'd like to beg to differ with you. Nothing brings a smile to a child's heart more than first period chemistry. But as you could see, Olivia already has a smile on her face, and that's how she shows up every morning for first period chemistry, ready to go. The reason she's up here, she is one of my top performers. If she ever has a question, she comes right in, will ask of me, but then takes that right back to her lab table. Other students in the class just always willing to be out there and helping. In a few years, I'd like to see you back as my student teacher for chemistry, no pressure. But again, just every time she comes in, her manners, a testament to her parents, how polite she is. She walks in, says hello every morning, has yet to leave a class and not thank me for chemistry, thanks me when I hand her a chemistry test. I mean, isn't not the best class to have first period in the morning? What else would you want to take? Physics next year, see you there. But again, just a great student to have. Everyone would be lucky to have a student like Olivia in their course. So.
All Great job, Olivia. And next we have Mr. Thomas, who is going to present to Chloe.
Good morning. My name is Mr. Thomas. I teach our radio and television introduction course here at South Campus, and I also run WLTL as a club. And we're unique in that we have both opportunities. Kids can take it as a class, or they could just do it as a club. Chloe has chosen to do both, which we're very thankful for. Chloe came into our class as a freshman and had, I don't want to say no desire to get started with it, but just like any freshman, just kind of first hour, just there and trying to see what it all involved. And she broke her foot about, what, 9 weeks ago probably now, 10 weeks ago? I won't tell you how. Saving orphans from a fire. So she broke her foot, and she couldn't do cheerleading anymore and came to me and said, you know, could I get started with WLTL? And tryouts had already happened, and we already were going for a year. And we said, absolutely, let's get you started. So she came over to North Campus, and instead of being, you know, down that she couldn't do the things she really wanted to do, she said, I'm going to try something new and try put myself out there. And as a freshman, took a job at WLTL that is one that most people don't want to do, and that's behind-the-scenes work, production, things you hear on the air but aren't live, aren't the DJ shows. Radio and television and all these things that we watch and are entertained by are full of thankless jobs. We all see the anchors and the hosts, but we never see the people behind the scenes. And Chloe became one of the people behind the scenes and took to it just immediately. And that's not super rare for a freshman, but it's pretty rare. What's more rare is that the quality of Chloe's work actually made it on the air. A lot of times what our freshmen do, we listen to and we evaluate and we feedback and they try again and again and again, and then finally it makes it on the air because it has to get up to a certain standard to be heard by anybody that wants to listen to WLTL. And Chloe's first piece, she played it for me and brought me in, and I was like, yeah, that's going on the air, which is pretty rare for a freshman. And she has stuck with it and just been an integral part of our behind-the-scenes work at WLTL. And we're appreciative of that for the club aspect. And your performance in class has been fantastic as well. And I'm appreciative of that as a first-hour teacher as well. Must be a first-hour thing today. So, Chloe, thank you very much for everything you've done for us at WLTL.
Great job working behind the scenes, Chloe. And next we have Ms. Donahue, who is going to present Ivan to us.
Good morning. I have the pleasure of having Ivan in world history class. Since the first day of school, Ivan has been an amazing student to have in class. He comes in eighth period, eager, still ready to learn after a very long day already, with an enthusiastic and positive attitude. He's often a leader in our classroom discussions and brings really thought-provoking, mature, in-depth questions to the conversations that I had not even thought of. He doesn't shy away from discussing his views, learning about those other views, which is exactly what we want in a social studies class, is to, you know, get these discussions going. Ivan has a genuine interest in the topic and could discuss topics from the rise of totalitarian dictators to the true meaning of religion for probably the full 48 minutes if I'd allowed him to. He could just keep going, which is great, okay, and that's what we want. Ivan is also well-liked and trusted by his peers. He gets along well with everyone. He will step up and help a student or explain a concept when they're struggling without me asking him to do so. Apart from his classroom performance, Ivan is friendly outside of class. And, you know, with both teachers and peers, he's respectful and responsible, always says hello to me in the hallway. I think I pass by you maybe three or four times a day in the halls, and still every time I get a friendly hello with a smile. Ivan's also easy to talk to. He's not just a great student, but also a wonderful person overall. I'm lucky to have such a positive influence in my classroom every single day, and I'm excited to see where his future at Lyons Township will take him. So for all these reasons, I'm pleased to award him with the Social Studies Student of the Month Award.
Great job, Ivan. As a former social studies teacher, I love those students that you can go to for discussion, so awesome job. Next, we have Mr. Danner, who is going to present for driver's education, and he's going to present Peter.
Thank you. I have Peter Acanero in classroom driver's education and also behind the wheel. Behind the wheel, you know, we have the cars that have the big yellow sign on top that's had the turn signal on for about the past 5 minutes and is driving about an inch from the curb to the right. That's us. But it's not Peter, right? Peter? Yeah, it's not you. Peter is the selection for the whole department in driver education. Peter has demonstrated outstanding work ethic in the classroom and a strong desire to perform well and improve his grades. In addition, Peter is very motivated to drive behind the wheel and has an outstanding attitude. You know, a lot of kids can be a little bit critical when they're partnered up with someone else and they go behind the wheel and there's some conversations coming back. It's always positive with Peter. He does an outstanding job. Peter is a great classmate, which is probably the most important thing. He's very understanding of his fellow classmates and always willing to help. Peter has had a great impact on his class and shows great pride in the relationships that he has developed and the environment that he has helped to foster in our class. So I'm very thankful to have Peter in class. Look forward to doing everything I can to help him learn to drive. So again, from the entire Driver Education Department, congratulations and keep up the good work, Peter.
Congratulations again, Peter. Next, from Physical Education Department, we have Mr. Brower. I don't think his student could make it today, but he's going to present a little bit about Cormac.
Good morning. Cormac was out sick yesterday, so it's kind of no surprise that he is not here. But obviously, to speak on his behalf, I've been here for 13 years, and it's nice to come into a PE class and have a kid who genuinely loves everything that you're doing. I don't think we've found one activity yet so far this year that Cormac has not enjoyed, so he was a very easy choice when I was asked to present one student for the Student of the Month. Cormac's my Student of the Month because of the energy and work ethic that he displays on a daily basis in my class. He brings a level of excitement and enthusiasm that is contagious for everyone in our class. Not only does Cormac work extremely hard, but he also motivates his peers to do exactly as he is doing in our class. He's extremely competitive, but he is also very respectful of all of everyone's different talent and ability levels that we display throughout our different activities. There's the term PE warrior that gets thrown around very often, and I think it's a good term for Cormac because of what he does every single day, not only for himself, but for everyone else. He's a true joy to have in class. He's the first person that I've legitimately had to pull out of the pool and say, you only have 2 minutes left to go to class to change, because he continually wanted to go off the diving board over and over and over again. But he's one of those kids that if we could fill a class of 36 of him, obviously our PE class would be very competitive, but also it would be very respectful of everyone's ability levels, which is all you can ask for in a class that takes not only prep level kids, but Excel level kids. There is only one PE class and we bring them all together, and he does a great job being a leader in our class. So Cormac Ryan is my Student of the Month. It's unfortunate that he cannot be here, but I will be sure to pass this on to him. He was very excited when I told him he was the Student of the Month, so I know he'd be disappointed that he's not able to make it today. So congratulations to Cormac.
Thank you, Mr. Brower. Finally, we have Mr. Ip from Student Services, who's going to present two students.
Good morning, and I am Mr. Ip. I am the, come on over, ladies. I am the proud sophomore counselor for the class of 2021. And my students have last names beginning with the letters A through H-A-H. So I also want to recognize all my other students are here at this breakfast. And I'm so proud to be able to work with so many of you. Unlike teachers, I don't have the opportunity to see students every day, but I cherish every opportunity that I have to work with my students. And today I have the distinct pleasure of recognizing Mira Dedia and Colette Doyle as our department's Students of the Month. After submitting compelling essays for their applications and completing interviews for a panel from a panel of unbiased staff members, so I was not part of that panel, Mira and Colette were selected as our sophomore representatives to attend the Hugh O'Brien Youth Leadership Conference, also known as HOBE. This annual conference invites selected school representatives from all over the Chicagoland area to attend a 3 to 4 day seminar to participate in hands-on leadership workshops, meet leaders in our state, and explore personal leadership skills while learning how to lead others and make positive impact in our community. Mira and Colette will be provided lifelong leadership development opportunities that will empower them to recognize their leadership talents and to apply their talents to become more effective, ethical leaders in their home, school, and community. I'm very fortunate to have both students as my counselees. I'm also glad that I was not on this panel to select our representatives. It was an extremely competitive pool of applicants, and I remember walking by the group of students being interviewed, and several of them were my students as well. Both young women share similar qualities and traits. Calm, altruistic, empathetic, and assertive are just some of the words that easily describe both students. In order to distinguish these two young ladies, I decided to solicit some comments directly from teachers who have the advantage of seeing them every day. So Mira, according to her teachers, is an intelligent and capable student who has impressed me with her ability to succeed academically with poise and maturity. She consistently explores concepts on her own to obtain answers through her hard work and inquiry. She stands out as a leader when gathering collective ideas with her fellow classmates, and she has the innate ability to break down and explain her thinking process in a coherent, sophisticated manner. She is an intelligent, empathetic young woman. She is inquisitive, and she can easily make connections in a class like this that combines academic learning with real-life experiences. Mira is a leader among her peers, and in group situations, she encourages others to produce their best work. Mira's diligence enables her to be successful in our class, and her kind approach towards her classmates makes her a role model for her peers. Mira treats her classmates with respect and willingly helps them when they are struggling with the content. She worked with them so they can gain a greater understanding of the material. Her comprehensive approach towards her studies illustrates Mira's determination to learn as much as she can about a given topic, and then she's able to connect her knowledge to other time periods, thus finding the value in learning the material. Mira is a steadfast student, and she shares her many gifts with others, her knowledge, her warmth, and her humor. Colette, in this class, Colette leads by example. She has had at least one article she has written for class get picked up and published on the Lion newspaper website. She is writing real news about LT topics for a real audience. Colette is such a ray of smiling sunshine in the early morning. I appreciate her willingness to participate and engage so actively in her own learning. Colette is easygoing, friendly, and socially sophisticated. Her outgoing and genuinely curious personality has allowed her to adapt to just about any social group or situation. She is down to earth, unpretentious, and her peers appreciate her sincerity and generosity. Colette's ability to work with a variety of different people with distinctly different needs and abilities and to make them feel valued is clearly one of her greatest traits. Colette's personal values are a priority, and rarely is she willing to compromise on anything that is important to her. Colette is more likely to listen attentively while waiting patiently to assert her insights and opinions in a timely manner. She is always respectful of her peers, teammates, and opponents. Clearly, with young leaders like Mira and Colette, our future is full of hope and promise. Congratulations, both of you, and LT looks forward to recognizing your great achievements to come.
At this time, we're observing a moment of silence. And now we stand for saying the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you, LZ. Have a fantastic Friday.
Thank you, Mira and Colette, for being such great examples of leadership in our school. That does conclude our Student of the Month ceremony for today. Before we leave, I would like to thank a couple people today. Sodexo for providing our breakfast for us. I'd like to thank LTTV and Candy Faye back there for filming for us today. I'd like to thank Mr. Hartley and the Madrigals again for their presentation this morning. They were awesome. I'd like to thank Vicki Parody in the back, one of my secretaries who puts this all together. And students, congratulations. You have set yourself apart from the other students with your hard work, commitment, your integrity, thoughtfulness, academic success, leadership, and positive attitude that you display every day. And last but certainly not least, I want to thank and congratulate the parents. And I know Mr. White alluded to some of this earlier. Without your continual support, commitment, and guidance, we wouldn't have such fine citizens that we get to recognize this morning. So thank you guys for coming. Thank you for your support. And before we leave today, I'd like to have all the Students of the Month that are still here gather for a picture, if there are any still here. And thank you guys.